You're listening to the Franchise Freedom Podcast with Giuseppe Grammatico.
Welcome to the Franchise Freedom Podcast. I'm your host, Giuseppe Grammatico, your franchise guide, the show where we help corporate executives experience time and financial freedom via franchising. Thanks for joining us today. Excited for this one. This is a show that I usually try to create every few months, and it's the top five franchise questions answered. Some of these are repetitive, but I do like to bring them up because I do realize that some people have maybe not listened to the show going back beginning of the year. So thanks for your questions. These are questions that I get via email, social media comments, YouTube, as well as questions I get from candidates. So I jot them down. I have an Excel document jotting all the questions down. And I said, you know what, let's tackle them. I do have some shows where we go in a little bit more detail. So I'll link them to this episode in the show notes. And again, looking forward to your questions. I'm gonna create more of these. And if anyone has any questions or they want to go in a little bit more detail, I'm gonna put my email here, gg@ggthefranchiseguide.com. You can email me directly. You can go just here to the domain, ggthefranchiseguide.com, and schedule a call if you're ready to have a chat and prefer to have a chat. There's no cost for our services, and I look forward to these calls and really helping address questions and concerns. So let me hide this. So let's talk about the five questions in no particular order that we get. So this is, again, from all sources. So number one is, can I lose money with a franchise? So the number one question that we've been, or one of the, I should say, the top questions we're getting is, can I lose money with a franchise? The answer is yes. We just recorded a show called The Mindset Shift You Need when exploring business ownership and investments. And we talk about, as with anything, the risk reward. So with a franchise, the investment sky is the limit when it comes to success. But yes, there is an investment risk, putting money or investing money, things for whatever reason may or may not work out. And we talked about placing the odds in your favor, doing your research, doing the proper due diligence research, speaking with the franchisor, speaking with the franchisee, meeting with the franchisor in person, the founders, C-suite, top level guys in the business that can talk about the vision and the direction of the business. So you want to minimize the risk, but you also want to look at the potential of investing in a business or any investment as to the return, as to not just the financial return, but the return as far as time, where maybe you go from a 40-hour a week work week in your W-2 salaried position to owning a business and working a couple hours a week, maybe just working and connecting with your general manager. So can I lose money with the franchise? The answer is yes. You want to minimize it via the franchise support and also purchasing, or I should say investing in the right franchise for you, given the support structure. And also, just as important, the role you will play in the business. Just because a franchise company, other people have done well, does not mean you will do well. If it's a opportunity where you are need to be very going out there doing sales and podcasts, just like today, webinars and events. If you're introverted and the thought of jumping on a podcast or an in-person event and presenting scares you, maybe that franchise is not the right fit for you. So that is the quick answer there. Secondly, how do I know I am a good fit for a franchise? So the second question, am I a good fit, or how do I know I am a good fit for a franchise? And this is a very good question. Not everyone is a good fit for a franchise. The people that are a good fit for a franchise are open to following a system, following the process of the franchise. And, if you are looking to buy a food franchise and completely change the menu of the franchise, probably not a good fit for a franchise. If you are, doing your due diligence, and the franchisor typically will have you do, two, three, four phone calls and then introduce you to the franchisees, and you struggle with following a process and you want to work in reverse and you want to speak with franchisees day one before anything else, or get the contract and change the process of the due diligence process of the franchisor, probably not a good fit. Because if you cannot follow the due diligence process from the franchisor, it's going to be difficult to follow the franchisor when you open up that business. So, and that's not a negative thing. It just may be that you want to invest in a different type. Maybe it's a non-franchise business, but following a system is going to be key. Following the process is going to be key. You know, if you have experience in the industry, you know, we'll throw the, which we use, the painting or the cleaning business. And if you have experience in one area and you're not opening to new ideas and using different technology and green chemicals or different paints and ways of actually applying the paints and things like that, may not be a good fit for a franchise. A franchisor is not looking necessarily for experience in that industry most of the time. They are looking for a skill set. Number one, are you open to following the process and the system? And number two, you know, you have experience, great, but what is the skill set needed? And, you know, going back to, you know, can I lose money with the franchise? You know, if you're looking for someone who's an extrovert, they're going to, that's something that's going to come up, you know, because in every conversation, it's really a two-way interview. You're interviewing the franchisor, they're interviewing you. And if you're portraying that you're having a hard time with marketing and sales, or I should say sales, and going out and presenting and things like that, franchisor is not going to wait until the very end when they award you the franchise or don't award you the franchise. That conversation may be had with myself, with yourself, or a combination, just saying, this is a concern of mine, may not be a good fit at this point, given the role. Or they may come back and say, if, you know, we continue and proceed with the business, you know, and you want to work part-time in the business, we need to make sure you're a key employer, your first hire is a salesperson, because that salesperson is really going to be running that business with sales and, you know, producing revenue in the very beginning. So hopefully that's helpful. We did a show on that as well. My favorite one, and maybe I should have did this one, is what are the top franchises? And the answer is, as always, and people I know get annoyed with me with this one, is it depends. I know what the top franchise are as far as sales, but what does that have to do with you? What does that have to do with you as far as the franchise you should look at? So for example, I had someone look at the top list. I think it was one of the top magazines. We won't name names. And they looked at a list and they said, well, I want to explore this. And I said to them, you're not a good fit. And almost annoyed, they came back and said, well, how can you tell me I'm not a good fit? And I said, very simple. You want a business that is able to be run part-time. That franchisor does not, it requires you to be full-time in the business. So with these top lists, in many cases, we do not know if they are a good fit simply because of the type of ownership. Are they full-time or they allow semi-absentee? There are a lot of franchises that want you in the business full-time, leaving your job, you know, for the first 6 months to a year. And that's their franchise avatar, someone that's going to learn the business inside and out so that they know what roles they want to play in the business and what employees they will need. And there's nothing wrong with that. It's not based off of industry. That's franchisor specific. So, you know, if we're looking at the water and smoke mitigation restoration business, you know, one may have you allow part-time, one will allow you to be full-time. One will allow you to just work on the business and hire a GM. One will have you actually going out and doing the work, right? Two different scenarios, same exact, similar business, same exact industry. So it really, you know, it really depends on what you're looking for. It also depends on your investment. You know, some people look at some of these larger restaurant chains and they pass them every day and they love it, but you know, maybe they have a net worth that just they financially don't qualify. You know, a franchisor has financial requirements and there's a liquidity requirement, cash on hand, cash savings, investments, non-retirement investments that you have readily available to you. And they'll also look at net worth. And, you know, some of them are going to be larger. And if you don't qualify, there you go. There's another reason, you know, they may not be a good fit at this time. You know, finally, territory availability. There are franchises, the more established brands that just don't have any turf, we call it, whether it be territory or location availability in your market. Your market may not be a good market, maybe very rural, and they require a higher population density in the business. So these are things to look for. And you know, where you live, what type of investment, what time commitment can you make in the business? Not just, You know, people say I can do 20 hours a week, but we have to look at the time sensitivity of the business. Are these, you know, a couple hours, nights and weekends? Can you, with time sensitivity, can you be available during the day? Because there are things that are going to pop up during the day. A lot of people, it's becoming less of an issue because they get to work from home. So they have their W-2 job 40 hours a week, but they can spend their lunch break easily, maybe another hour or so a day in the business. So when you peel it back and look at what are the top franchises, the top franchise companies are the brands that fit what you are looking for. So investment, time availability, location, and the list goes on. The role that the franchisor will play, employees, the number of employees. What are your employees? What's the mix of W-2 versus 1099 contractors? Do you prefer one versus the other, and that kind of thing? So, anytime someone asks me, you can easily get that data on a website. I personally think it's useless data, just because what are we looking for? How many units they sold? Well, how does that have anything to do with the match for you? So I encourage everyone, take a look at some recent episodes, but really figure out what your ideal business looks like. Write it down on paper. Not what if this, what if that, just what does it look like? If it's working from home versus working at a retail or opening up a retail location, if it's part-time to start versus full-time, what type of investment? Keeping in mind there are funding options, but what type of cash? Look at the cash injection. You know, how much money out of pocket are you looking to invest? If you have a smaller amount, you know, brick and mortar may be out of the question, depending on the loans you can get. So that's my response to the top franchises. Some people have a requirement and they come back and say, well, I want it to be something recession resistant. Okay. That's part of it as well. What is recession resistant? And sometimes that's a conversation to be had, but you know, things like water and smoke restoration mitigation, that's, you know, a little bit more recession resistant, getting tongue tied today, where there's a need regardless of the economy, regardless of what's going on in the world. There's going to be natural disasters. There's going to be flooding. There's going to be fires, and those need to be addressed. So those are areas to look at. But again, so don't jump to the list and say, well, what are the top restoration brands? Well, if they require you to be full-time and you don't have that availability, not going to work for you. So be more than glad to see what else is recession resistant. And some people may feel certain industries are recession resistant. Some people may not believe they are. So it's a conversation to be had, and would love to help you and continue that conversation. Where to start? How do you start in this whole process? This goes back to the top franchises. Let's figure out, what you're looking to accomplish. So, going back to previous episodes, but figuring out your goals, why are you looking at a business in the first place? I get a lot of people saying, I want to make more money. I want to have more time. Great. You know, is it just, are you just not liking your job? You know, what's the path? Is the path to leave your job by the end of the first year of owning a business? You know, can you work this job full time? Can you just leave your job right now? Can you apply full time effort to the business? So it's figuring out the reason you're looking for a business, your time frame, your investment, and things like that. But as far as where to start, I highly recommend not looking at franchise brands themselves. Just like my coach worked with me back in 2005, we explored, okay, what does the ideal day look like? What am I looking to accomplish? What is my time frame for myself? You know, we had, my wife was working, we were just in the process of starting a family. So I left my job, very well-paid job on Wall Street, to start the business full-time. And, you know, we had to cut back on certain things and no vacations and things like that. But, we cut back, and that was fine. You know, maybe we ate out less and we didn't vacation the first year, but we were able to get the business up and running and believe it or not, profitable, first year. And we were only in business 10 months. The first year, 10 months. Yeah. 10 months, the first year. So that's not the case for everyone. You know, you may be profitable much sooner or maybe well after the first year. So, things to consider, but where to start is not the brands. That's going to cause massive anxiety and confusion. Figure out the ideal situation, what you want your ideal business to look like. If it's from home, retail opportunity, brick and mortar, do you prefer customers coming to you? Or, the customers come to you via retail, you going to the customers, a service-based business? What is your investment? Are you okay diving in full time? Do you have the financial means? Do you have savings in there to pay your mortgage, your rent, and your personal expenses, considering you're going to need healthcare as well? Can you cover that with savings, or do you just want to, do it kind of part-time the first year and get into business eventually full-time after the first year? And then the last question I get is autonomy. Is there going to be, I'm concerned with the franchise because they will have no autonomy. The franchisor will be telling me what to do. Now, each franchise is going to function differently. This is a great question. And you're buying a franchise for their system. You're buying the franchise because they figured out the best and ideal way to run that business. So when it comes to autonomy, yes, there is definitely going to be autonomy. And when it comes to the role of the franchisee. So first off, some franchisors are going to be flexible what role you play. If you want to be the GM, if you want to be full-time, part-time, if you just want to lead the sales efforts and be the salesperson and have a general manager, operations manager in place. When it comes to marketing, you have the ability to continue the marketing. You're going to, first off, review the current marketing plan. And if that franchisor offers you a marketing, turnkey marketing with a call center, you'll get to review, make changes, review the KPIs, figure out if the quality of leads is there. If you're not closing enough sales, is it the salesperson? Meaning that the salesperson need to go to retraining, or is it just they're getting very low quality? So even with the best salesperson, those leads are just not qualified. With autonomy, you can decide to, put together a podcast. And, we had someone looking at an executive recruitment franchise, and they're like, I really like podcasts. I always wanted to create one myself. And I said, great, here to help and give you advice. And he's like, maybe I can run a podcast talking about general ideas like your LinkedIn profile, resume writing, in general interview topics, best practices, and things like that. What to write in your cover letter, bringing on different individuals that have expertise. So you can absolutely have autonomy there. Many franchisors allow you to have an office or work from home, expand the business. Some of these, going back to recruitment or business coaching, if you want to do it on your own or have a team and really scale the business. So there's absolutely autonomy in the business. If you're buying a food franchise, you're going to follow the menu and work within the guidelines. So the autonomy is going to be how you run the business, when you're able to scale the business, your role in the business, and things like that. So there's absolutely autonomy, flexibility in the business, keeping in mind you're buying the franchise for that system. And as I talk about in my book, Franchise will give you that unfair advantage because, right out the gate, you're not figuring out the brands and, what services or products to offer. That's all been taken care of for you so that you can just run with the business. We use, I call it a business on training wheels, a business in a box that you can get up and running much faster, especially in a service brand. I mean, I have guys opening up and I've seen guys open up in 30 to 90 days, business coaching, painting, restoration, the list goes on. I think the only time it takes a little bit longer and it gets you past, 30 days and gets you more in the 60 to 90 is there's vehicles involved, equipment. You need to wrap the vehicles, get the proper equipment and things like that. So let's review the five top questions. Can I lose money in a franchise? Yes. Am I a good fit for a franchise? Do you follow a process and can you follow systems? What are the top franchises? Who cares? Let's figure out what the top franchise is for you. Where do I start? Don't look at existing franchise brands. Look at what your ideal business looks like. What are your requirements in the business? What is your role in the business? And autonomy, hell yeah, there's plenty of autonomy in a business, in a franchise business, and we'd love to help you out. So let me put here again, questions, GG at ggthefranchiseguide.com. Would love to help you out. Email me directly. If you go directly to my website, ggthefranchiseguide.com, you could book a call, 20 minutes. It's a free call. There's never a cost for our services. We can help you out in figuring out if a franchise is a good fit. If you're not ready to chat, download the book, same website, /book. You'll see a big area up top. Click on the, I believe it's on the free resources. We're launching a new website as we speak. You can download my book. It's a exactly 30-minute read on building that. Not just, you know, is a franchise a good fit? We talk about setting up the right team, you know, in, you know, the best practices of going about looking at a business, informing your family and everyone involved. I think this is just some priceless information, things I've implemented, learned over the years. It's my exact blueprint in helping you find a franchise. Check it out. It's free. If you want a hard copy, go to Amazon. I believe it's under $5. The Kindle version is much less. So check it out. Appreciate your support. Appreciate your questions. Until the next time, talk to you guys soon. Bye-bye.
Thanks for tuning in. Whenever you're ready, here are three ways Giuseppe can help. 1, if you've ever considered owning a business of any kind, you owe it to yourself to get a copy of Giuseppe's book, Franchise Freedom. Download your free copy at ggthefranchiseguide.com/book. 2, want to understand how successful executives make the transition from corporate to owning their own franchise? Join Giuseppe's next online presentation, Franchise Freedom: How to Escape the Corporate World and Have Financial and Time Freedom by Owning a Franchise, by going to ggthefranchiseguide.com/video. 3, want to work with Giuseppe one-on-one to identify the right franchise opportunity for you, to navigate the process, and get plugged into experienced franchising advisors? Send him an email to gg@ggthefranchiseguide.com with one-on-one in the subject, and he'll send you all the details.